Okay everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to be taking a look at the Assetto Corsa Competition A track guide for Silverstone on the PS4 version. This lap was done in the special events that is currently on the PS4 version. Not sure if it's on the PC version as well. It's very possible it is. I haven't really played the PC version that much. I've obviously got the PC version, but now the PS4 version is out, I am much more motivated to try and get my PC able to play and stream at the same time this game, because I'm thoroughly enjoying it, and also it'd be nice to play at a slightly higher frame rate. But yeah, it's still playable on PS4. It does need some improvements, but yeah, the physics are there, that is the main thing. So I thought I would give you a track guide of my lap that I did. Now the track conditions are not optimal. I believe they're running ideal, which is slightly less grip than you'll get from optimal. So yeah, the lap times are a little bit slower than what you physically can do if the track is in its best condition. Also, I'm not too sure about the temperatures that were being run on this special event. I do know that I had the aggressive setup with a few basic changes to tire pressures, and I made a bit of a mistake with, I thought because it's a single lap it might be a good idea to run zero brake vents on the front. I think that was a mistake. I probably should have put one brake vent just to keep the tires a little bit of air into them, to cool them down a bit when then brakes were heating up. But yeah, we managed to get a lap in. So for this track guide, it's not really about the setup. I'm just letting you know that we used the aggressive setup with, I think we put ABS down to 3, which I'm not sure if that was perfect on the ideal settings. Maybe we could have used 4. And traction control, we went down to 2. Maybe on the traction control, I think maybe 3 would have been better, because the track was not at its optimal condition. So maybe running 3 traction control might help you out a little bit in terms of lap time as well. I'm interested to try this lap out in the future, in a couple of days, when I can get back on with the setup that I've got now, because I think we might be able to push for 3 or 4 attempts off of this lap that we've done here. But still, I think this lap is solid enough to give you some sort of basic guidance to Silverstone in a GT3 car. And obviously we're using the Bentley for this guide, an absolute monster of a car that just rides curbs like they're not there. So starting the lap, try and give yourself a nice clean exit off the final corner to give yourself some good acceleration and drive out of that corner. Now we're going to be working our way into turn 1, where we're going to be looking for the 50 board. So the 50 board is kind of a little clue as when you're going to chuck the car in. So you're going to slow it down here. You can see I'm going to dab the little bit of braking input here just before the 50 board, and we're going to chuck the car in. And we're going to go down to 4th gear, because obviously the track was not optimal conditions. If it is optimal, I think you can do that in 5th gear. And you're really going to attack this apex here. You can see you can actually get the car up on the curb, and there's plenty of grip with this Bentley. I will have to try this out with a different GT3 car to see if you can be as aggressive on that curb. But yeah, with the Bentley, it rides that curve beautifully as we now attack into the really fast flowing section. This is probably one of the best sections on Silverstone. As we into this corner, you want to get your left hand tire onto the curb for the first part, just to try and straight line this next section as much as possible. So it's all about widening the angles into these corners. So onto the curb. Now we're going to attack this section now with the Bentley again. Just look how much of this corner you can take off with the Bentley. You can really get up on the curb and it doesn't really get affected by it. So yeah, onto the curb here, still just a little lift off the throttle you'll see there. And now into the next brake zone, you're gonna see I'm gonna shift and a little dab of the brake at the same time to get the rotation in at the same time and hug the inside of this left hand corner. So yeah, that little shift really helps rotate the car. And now you're gonna be going down into third gear, doing something very similar with the shift and a little dab of the brake at the same time again. Rotation of the car with the shift gets the weight transferring and bites into this right hand side. And again, you can really get that right hand tire up on this curb and then on the throttle as early as possible. It's so important to get on the throttle very early after this corner, because it'll give you momentum all the way down this acceleration zone and obviously let that Bentley really pull all the way into the next braking zone. So we're going to power away all the way down this straight. I love listening to this Bentley when it's really singing. The sound effects on the set course are so good. As we go into the next braking zone, we're going to be looking to brake just before the curb on the right hand side. So I use that start of the curb as a little bit of reference to brake a little bit early. Obviously, the more track grip there is, the closer to that you can brake. And we're going to try and get the car into this apex and hug the apex. There is a lot of grip if you can get there, but it will run wide quite easily. Slightly miss the apex there, a little bit wide. Maybe could have done that a little bit better, but on the throttle nice and early. And now at this point, you want to try and straighten up the car. There's no point going back onto the track, because you're just making more distance for yourself to travel. So you're just going to try and keep it as straight as possible now. And then into the next braking zone, you'll see braking just past that little chicane board on the right hand side. So yeah, you're going to see the braking inputs going in here, and we're going to downshift into second gear, and I'm actually going to go into first gear briefly through here. You're going to see down to first gear and try and get the car to rotate into the apex on the throttle nice and early to try and get some acceleration, then upshift to second gear, and then a little lift off the throttle as we go into this corner. You can actually take a little bit of the corner off with the Bentley. I don't know if you're the same. I haven't tried other cars, so I'm not sure how they will react on that curb. But yeah, over the curb, little lift off, and then back on the throttle, and then powering out of this corner. And again, I do believe that I made a mistake with the setup by doing zero brake vent for this hot lap, because I remember on Project Cars we used to do it, but I don't think it worked quite so well for this game. But yeah, I've lessons learned for that. As we now go into the next braking zone, you're going to see just a dab of brake. I don't even think we go on the brake for this corner. You're going to see as we just lift and throw it in on the start of that green curb, lift off the throttle, and then now we're going to try and get our right hand tire onto the curb here. Now this is so important, just to skim that curb, powering through, use a little bit of the curb on the left hand side. You can see there's a little bit of green Astro there that's there for you to use as much as possible. You know, when you're pushing through there, it just gives you that little bit of extra grip. As we now work our way through this left hand corner, trying to keep the car to the left, it's really important because you're now going into a very heavy braking zone at high speed. And you can see I use the start of the curb as the reference. The closer to that you can brake is all down to the grip levels at the moment. We can't really push it too much as the track is not obviously in its optimal condition. And again, we're going to downshift the second gear and try and get it into that apex up here. So we transfer down to second gear and then just let it coast briefly through this corner before you get back on the throttle. This game does seem to really like it when you coast on the throttle, and that is one thing I really like about Assetto Corsa. It feels so natural and so realistic as we again going to try and get the swing the car to the right hand side, again using the end of the curb there as kind of a reference for your braking. You'll see now as we onto the brakes a little bit earlier than the line, obviously because the track grip's not 100%, and we're going to try and get this car into this apex. So going down to first gear is so important this corner to get the apex sorted and square the car off so you can get on the throttle as early as possible. There's a lot of time to be gained and lost on this corner here. It's probably the slowest corner on the track, but it's also possibly one of the most important corners for your lap time, because if you run slightly wide there, you can lose half a second very easily. Now we're just going flat out, no need to lift through here, it's completely flat all the way down this straight into the next heavy braking zone, which again, a corner where you can gain quite a bit of time if you really hook this next section up or if you make a mistake. So yeah, we're going to look for the board on the right hand side. You'll see there the turning in board. I make sure I brake it a little bit before that. You need to brake, obviously the more grip there is available on the track, the closer to it you can brake, but with Ideal have to brake a little bit earlier. So yeah, trying to hug this car in to the left hand side now in second gear. Again, you're going to take a bit of the curb off as you approach into the final part of this left hander, so just skimming that curb, accelerating out of the corner and staying to the right hand side. You can see I could swing it in, but I actually find there's not much benefit to doing that. It's actually quite good just to stay to the curb and stay where the grip is and try and hug the apex as much as possible. So you see that second gear, a little bit of braking inputs going in before we got into that corner. And then on the throttle as early as you can be very aggressive with the throttle if you get the line right and if you're not putting too much steering input in, and accelerating all the way over the start finishing line. And I think we're gonna go over the line for a 1:57.5, I think it is. Let's just check that out. Yeah, 57.5. Now there was potential to go, I think, quite a bit faster, especially if I get a setup sorted that's going to keep them tires in a nice range. Obviously the problem with this time trial is you want the tires to be at the perfect ideal point from the start of the lap, but maintaining them there is very difficult. Anyway, I'm going to let you watch that lap at full speed with no talking, so you can listen to the Bentley sing and you can pick up any more stuff while you're watching at the 100% speed. Anyway, hope you enjoyed this video. Leave a comment if it's helped you out, hit that like button if it's helped you out, and I'll see you for more videos very soon. Thanks again for watching, everyone.